everyone, and welcome to Beyond Focus TV. My name is Angie Daniel, and I am your hostess. Tonight's show is about a new beginning. It's a home that's being opened by a family, the Exemptus family. They are here to talk about how they're going to promote the community and helping the community while they're doing this big event, huge event, to try to raise funds just to help themselves get it through. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back, and I'll introduce them to you. And welcome back. Before we took a short break, I did tell you I was going to introduce you to the Exemptus family, Linda and Nikia. Welcome.
Hi, how are you?
Hello, how are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing well. A little bit tired, but I'm doing well. Mm-hmm. So, in all of my shows, I usually start by the introduction of the, you know, what it is that you do within the community, who you are, what you represent. So, I'll start with you, since you are the, you know, mother. Okay. I'll start with you first.
Well, my name is Linda. And we have a program that helps, you know, the non-privileged children, you know, so, and I will let Nikia continue.
Okay. So, I know that you, before we get into all of what you do for yourself, but tell us a little bit about the home in itself.
Well, the home is designed to help underprivileged children to pretty much get some sort of self-esteem and to get a new beginning, a new direction in life, which helps them to pretty much start their lives where they feel confident and they have self-esteem and they can accomplish anything they possibly want to.
Okay. So I know that the idea started with you, Linda, with how you felt like, I wouldn't call it a calling, I would say this is what you are meant to do within life. Because I think a lot of time situations happen and it creates a path for us, right? Mm-hmm. So tell us what your devotion and what you were aiming for before you started creating the home.
Okay, I could say pretty much that I love children.
Yes.
Always. Children, you know, has no color.
Mm-hmm.
And I have 5 children of my own. But over the years, I've raised over 47 children.
Wow.
So there were problems at home sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
Then I have to step in.
Mm-hmm.
So I could say, really, this is something that I love to do.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's when I was reading it, and then part of what I noticed is that, you know, like a lot of time people say, like, I'm going to open a home for young adults that are troubled, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you see a young adult that's troubled and you see a home, you know what the affiliation is within
right.
it. You understand?
Right.
But what I loved and understood and really liked the idea of the home that you guys have opened is how, one, it is not for just underprivileged kids. It's for kids that have been challenged physically and mentally.
Yes.
So tell me your part within it. How do you feel like, you know, you wanted to empower these young people?
Well, I must say that I've been affected with the bug that my mother implanted.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just growing up, I didn't know why I was getting kicked out of my room for total strangers. But now I understand. To be able to provide a safe haven, and that's what this home feels like. It's not what you said.
Mm-hmm.
Where it's the typical, you know, drug troubled teens.
Yes.
You know, it's not like that. When you walk into the home, you just feel a sense of serenity and peace. It's just designed very modern style, bright colors. I mean, it's really luxury, to tell you the truth.
Mm-hmm.
And so that in itself, when a child is proud of where they live, you know, the neighborhood is, you know, exquisite.
Mm-hmm.
The school district is exquisite. So they get the best of the best. So they start to feel that they are, you know, the best.
Yeah. I mean, I think for me, once you create a certain home values, right? And you said it, you've raised 47 kids, mm-hmm. not just five. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times, you know, people take in situations and make it their own. And for you to say that, you know, like looking at you, probably mm-hmm. they can't see that, but you look very young. And once you enjoy, mm-hmm. no, it is true. Yeah. Once you enjoy what you do, once yeah. your life on an everyday basis is making a difference into something that you like to do and, mm-hmm. and you don't feel it as like, you helping others, it just becomes part of you.
Right.
And then this is where it creates your calling, it creates yeah. your basis. Yeah,
exactly.
So for you to have this home, and then for you to bring other kids within it, like your own personal home, when I heard the story, I don't know if you mind me sharing
okay.
that,
I don't have a problem.
And I'd like your input in it. Mm-hmm. Like how did you, what was the basis of the home that you created? I don't want to tell your story. I would like for you to tell your story. Like, how did you start the home? What
okay.
was the reason?
Pretty much, I have my son Josh, mm-hmm. JX, you know, who was signed by MUSA Capital Record. Mm-hmm. And he was 21 when he was signed. And I didn't want him pretty much to blow his money, to spend his money. So I told them that he needed to put down payment on a house. Mm-hmm. And which he listened to me. He says, Mom, I'm too young. I don't need a big home.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, you know, do it. You never know what can happen to the music. So just do it. So he listened to me. So we purchased the home. But after a while, I says, 5 bathrooms, 9 rooms. At this point of my, you know, at this point of time, what do I need such a large room?
Mm-hmm.
So I started to think, what I'm going to do with this home?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then I spoke to them, I spoke to all my children and all my family's members. Mom, what do you like to do best?
Yes.
You've been doing it all your life. Mm-hmm. So why not doing something productive with the home? Okay. That's how, you know, it started.
Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. I think, like talking to you and I thought, wow, this makes such, you know, you're going to feel... I'm speaking mm-hmm. from my own little personal experience. When mm-hmm. you once you're doing something that you really like and you really mm-hmm. enjoy, mm-hmm. you know, and it's just it keeps reincarnated mm-hmm. in itself. Not only that, you're gonna have you have 9 rooms and look at us. You already had the basis, mm-hmm. although you didn't know how far it was gonna go.
Mm-hmm.
Him buying a house
yes.
created that path for you to mm-hmm. help those young kids.
Mm-hmm.
So and your talent. So let's talk about your talent within this home.
Okay.
I know you're, you know, tell the public that what you do on a regular basis before I explain to them, like, how you fit into
okay.
the home.
Okay. Well, just to start off with, my mother taught us how to play piano and introduced us to music at a very young age, just at 5, and then started training in classical music and had ballet, tap, jazz, was very, very well versed in the arts, went to conservatories. Presently, I have a Hands Up Entertainment mm-hmm. company, which puts together events and concerts, and I also teach, you know, all ages, starting from 2 to 65. But in my college years, I decided to study psychology
mm-hmm.
and worked as a recreational therapist.
Wait, let's stop right there.
Okay.
That's where I want
okay,
to go.
Yes.
I mean, you know how sometimes you create whatever the butterfly is going to be.
Yeah.
So I wanted to, you know, it's so cool to see this, to
yeah.
see how, as a family, how, you know, it was implanted in you.
Yes.
And how you've created your creation and how your kids get involved.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to talk about how Nakia is involved into making the home a better place for the kids. We'll be right back. Welcome back. We are here with Nakia Exantis and her mother, Linda, talking about what we call a house of new beginnings. And I love the way you guys have it, like house of new beginnings of Exantis.
Yes.
You know, it's not only that you have your name within it, but I love anything that starts with beginning. You know, that's why I love New Year's.
Yeah.
I really do. I love New Year's. You could just like leave everything behind and start over.
Mm-hmm.
So you creating a home where kid, I wouldn't call it kids because this is like for younger adults or like age rank, right? We have an age rank where people can come to and fit in and start over and be able to feel like this is where I belong. Mm-hmm. It's not like, you know, I'm going through this. Because a lot of times I've been through homes where I see how it's run. I mean, a lot of time it's not to the best of the what we would call client or patient or resident, right?
Right, yes.
It's just a home that they're going through.
Right.
But with this new home, the new beginnings, there's so much that's happening. I know you play a really big part in it. So can you tell me a little bit about that?
So yes, when my mother was saying that we need to do something productive with this home and we started to converse about it, we realized that we all have a love of music. Mm-hmm. And all my siblings can attest to that, how it has helped us in many, many ways, just get into better schools, just to think and focus better with academics. You use your brain a certain way when you are introduced to music, especially at a young age.
Yes.
And so we decided that, you know, why not introduce music in this home? So it's not just your typical home, but it's given them an opportunity to really express themselves, to tap into things, certain potentials that they may never have known they had. And then that's something no one can take away from you. Like, if you have a gift, it's a gift. It's a gift from God, really, music. Mm-hmm. And to be able to tap into it and use it productively is a blessing in itself. So we decided to do that and use this home as something that my mom knows well, which is taking care of children and just really giving them a lot of love. And what we know, you know, my brothers and I, and even my mother, because she did teach us, like, the first beginnings of our introduction to music, and just put it all together, and that's what came out of it.
So I understand you do therapy.
Yes, yes, I do. In college, I studied psychology, and then I work as a recreational therapist, which uses music and art as a form of therapy. Okay. So I know firsthand. I work with different communities. I work with the brain injured. And I also work with the elderly. And there's scientific fact that when you introduce music in some kind of form of therapy, it definitely helps the patients or the residents to get better, you know, health-wise and emotionally.
Okay.
So this is why I felt like this would be a great opportunity to use what I know, my background in psychology and music, and put it together.
So I don't want to lose the community and stuff. So what we're talking about is a house of new beginnings. It is a home for, you know, mentally or physically challenged young adults, or that are, you know, that will not be able to help themselves. So they have a place to go. They have a 9-bedroom. So and you know, like, it's a big home where you can belong within a family.
Yeah,
you know, that's helping you. Mm-hmm. So now we have therapy.
Yes.
What I wanted the community to know is that right now we're doing this big YouTube event that we're trying to raise funds.
Yes.
Because of, you know, like, just getting it from point, it's like A, B, C, and D now. We just want to get it to the Z part.
Yes.
Like, because it's not fully functional right now, right?
Right, exactly.
So tell us about the event.
Well, the event is coming up. It's July 15th. That's a Sunday at 6 p.m. And it will be held at 170 Post Avenue at Shamey Lane, which is in Westbury, Long Island. And we're very excited about it because we want to get the community involved and we want everyone to have a hand in making this happen. So, yes, we want to raise funds because it does take money.
It does take money.
That's just the bottom line.
Everything takes money.
Yeah, that's the bottom line of it. So we're very realistic about that. But we want the community, because it does take a community to build something like this. And so everyone can say,
you know, the whole, it takes a village.
Right, exactly. You know? And you're giving back. And when you give back, it is true that there's more pleasure in giving than there is in receiving.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it's a way of giving back some way, somehow, to children who wouldn't have this opportunity.
You know, and like, I know when I spoke to you earlier, talking about the idea behind the home in itself, right? The idea behind it. It's so grand.
Yes.
What I wanted people to get out of it is what I got out of it, is not only that, you know, you're coming to an event for fundraising, but there's going to be so many different artists there.
Yes.
So She's like, oh yes. Talk about the people that are going to be there, the performers, the musicians, the talents. Besides yourself, because I know you're performing.
Yes, I'm performing.
Let's talk about the talents that are going
to
be there.
Yes, we have, well, my brother, who's Josh X, and he's signed to Capitol Records. He'll be there performing, as well as T. Mickey, which I'm sure many people know about, and he's crossing over into the mainstream genre. We also have a woman from Paris. She's a jazz singer, very, very well known in Paris. And she has agreed to fly all the way down from Paris to be part of this. And her name is Leah. And we also have another artist, Nicole, and she is signed to my brother, JX, and she'll be performing as well.
Okay.
And my brother, Genius, he's going to be on tour. He's a lyricist, very, very gifted. So it's a nice mix of just different people. And we have the band. Mom, can you introduce the band?
Yes, introduce the band.
The band, you know, is maybe the pronunciation, Zafem Ben, also going to be there. And we also have Lucien Siren, who is going to also play for us. And we have... I think Molière d'Oresti also going to be performing.
So it's a nice mix of people, for young, older, it doesn't matter. Music is music, it's very universal, and that's the whole thing. But tons of talent, so much excitement, and so much love behind it.
You know, and it's like when you look at the flyer, and you know, I've had a chance to not only talk to you guys and see it, we have so many performers, and the price is very little.
Yes, it is very little.
So can we talk about the price?
Because I could plug it in.
I could say, I mean, I could do my own commercial for this. You know, but I'd love for you guys, instead of me talking about it, I'd love for you guys to give your views on that.
And we forgot to mention we're going to have surprise celebrities.
Yes.
As well.
No, you can mention it now.
Yes, we're going to have celebrities as well. We are not mentioning the names because mainly for their safety.
So how much is the event?
The event is $25 online, but at the door will be $35 at the door.
And if I bring my better half, you know, if I bring my better half, it's $50, right?
Yes.
So it's $50 for my better half.
Yes.
But in all seriousness, you know, I wanted to come go back to the home itself. This is something I think the community needs. Because a lot of times we have facilities where it's there for younger adults who are able. We've never had a place where we have, you know, kids that are not able to function on their own, to have a home where they can go to. The idea that you bring in this forth, for me, it means a whole lot. So, you know, on my own, I know where I work at. Like, I've noticed, like, where kids have lesser values than, you know, like, the things that they are challenging in terms of doing or what's available to them. So for you to open that, and then you're opening it as a family, I think it's really big. It's really grand for us to do. We're going to take a short break, and when we come back, we're going to continue this conversation of how we are changing the community. So we're going to take a break. We'll be right back. Welcome back. We are here with the Exentis family talking about like specialty homes and how you feel like you wanted to make a difference. Part of my last question to you was that I always want to know why people pick to do certain things.
Yeah.
Why the physically challenged kids? Why that instead of like a regular?
Well, these kids have, there's a need for them to have a place to live. You can either hospitalize them, but really that's not a... the type of living anyone really wants to do. You know, you rather than be with family, have care all the time, but be in comfort. And so there is a huge need for this community of people. You know, developmental problems. So that's why we chose this community.
Okay. I know it's still pending in terms of, you know, it being open. Mm-hmm. So which county is it going to be at when it's done?
It's Nassau County, and it's in West Hempstead, Long Island.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just like housing for nine, like how many residents, or I don't like 12. To call them kids.
12, yeah. Right. Residents, 12 residents. It can fit more, but again, it's about comfort.
Yeah.
So you don't want to crowd anybody in. It's a huge, huge house. Again, it's beautiful. It really is. It's just designed and decorated well. And it's a home. It's
Are you hoping to create more homes after...
Yes, this definitely. Would be the starter,
yes.
The new beginnings, right,
yeah.
Of a journey, you know, to come. So this is the starting point for us.
Okay. That's my legacy.
That's your legacy?
Yes.
To create more
homes.
More homes, so you could have, because I know that you mm-hmm. talk about how you feel like you're a motherly figure within, you know, within all of this. Mm-hmm. So for you, what would be the one thing that you would want the community to know about this, from Linda's okay. point of view?
From my point of view, I was a single parent, you know, mm-hmm. divorced, got married very early, mm-hmm. divorced very early, and I had to, you know, work two jobs to really raise my children. And because music is my passion,
wow.
so I had to make sure I had my son who went to Juilliard, she went to Juilliard. So what I want to do in the home, if there's any of the kids who is musically talented, I would like my children, especially my son Josh,
mm-hmm.
who's signed in the industry,
mm-hmm.
for some of the artists, like Alicia Keys.
Mm-hmm.
My son spoke to her, and this is very close to her heart. She
yeah.
likes to get involved.
Yes.
For them to be able, each one of my children, for them to have a mentor, for to have mm-hmm. a sponsor,
okay.
you know, for somebody to really take an interest
yes.
and give them what I have given my children. Mm-hmm, which is
you know,
nice.
It's funny that as you're saying that, I'm thinking, you know how sometimes when kids are like in the Caribbean country, so I'll speak for my own group of people per se, right?
Mm-hmm.
Once someone is mentally challenged or physically challenged, we kind of like put them to the side.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
You understand?
Mm-hmm, that's
but
true.
To be able, I love the way you said that, to have a sponsor, someone to look out for you, someone to, you know,
mm-hmm.
become like, you know, under their wings,
yes,
like you're moving along
mm-hmm.
with them.
Yeah.
That is. You know, you never know. It might be your dream, but it might come true.
Yes.
It's, you know, you put it out there.
Yes.
You voice it out there.
Mm-hmm.
So before we end the show, I would like for you guys to talk about the event in itself. Like,
yes.
I would love for people to show up and you know, support. So
yes.
tell us a little bit more about the event,
okay.
where it's going to be at, and how much
yes.
it's going to be.
Okay, so it's going
and
to be...
And phone numbers and websites.
And the phone number and websites. It's going to be July 15th.
July 15th.
Which is a Sunday
mm-hmm.
at 6 p.m. Doors open at 6 p.m.
Okay.
It's going to be a DJ. There'll be food. There'll
mm-hmm.
be artists. Different sounding artists, very versatile, but something for everyone.
Okay.
So please, everyone, just come out and join July 15th at Chez Millet, which is at 170 Post Avenue, Westbury, New York, Long Island. You will not regret it. You will have a great time, and you're doing something for a great cause.
And how much is it again?
It's $25 in advance. You can go online. The website is newbeginninghouse.jimbo.com, JIMBO.com. You can go purchase online, or you can call 516-669-6318 or
718-759-3785.
So the number is 516-669-6318 or 718-749-3785.
And, you know, just in case if anybody, like even if you are not attending the event and you'd like to sponsor.
Yes.
Or, you know, support, because that's what we need. We need people to support one another in
yeah.
situations and event like this.
Yeah.
If you're, to me, I sponsor a whole lot of events, even if I'm not attending it.
Yeah.
The reason why, it's because once I see that someone is making a difference, doing something,
yes.
you know, positive
mm-hmm.
within the community.
Yeah.
It's always good to support that, because you never know who within your family, in your group of friends,
yes,
who's going to benefit from it.
That's so true. And there's an opportunity to make donations at the website newbeginninghouse.jimbo.com. You can go, you can give whatever,
you know,
whatever your heart feels compelled to do. It would be much appreciated.
Exactly. So, you know, this is the end of our show, and I really, really thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you.
For you guys to come here and share this with us. I am hoping the community will support, and, you know, of course, I'm going to be there.
Okay, yes.
And I'm hoping to bring a couple of my friends with me.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
Yes. So thank you so much for coming.
You're welcome. Thank you for the opportunity.
Nice meeting you.
No, it's nice meeting you.
Thank you.
This is the end of our show. I'm hoping that you guys, like, have learned as much as I have, or, you know, hopefully you'll be able to support, and you can reach them at the number that's at the bottom, or you can reach us if you need tickets. The producer, Dunwan, will be much able to help you. I'll see you next time, same place. Bye-bye.